Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Betrayal at Krondor. It's brought to you all by Jason, as per usual. You're just jumping on in here, and I was told there's a shop in North Warden. And we need it, because we're like starving to death. Half the party's dead. And sadness. There it is. Okay, so it might... I dare say it maybe only appears after you've talked with what's-his-face. I don't know. Let's see what they've got. We have another suit of dragon armor, which we could get for Patras, but for the time being, I am going to hold a no. We'll hold off on it. That having been said, we do have some crap we can vendor, which I am going to do. It's not a lot, but every little bit of change helps. How much will you give me for this ruby? Oh yeah, 148 sovereigns. We'll take it. Clerical oil cloths can go... yeah. Dragonstone can go. I think these are all junk. I still don't know if there's any use to this. I'm sure there is. I'm gonna hold on to it. Why am I even carrying this? Yeah, five sovereigns. Totally worthwhile, guys. By the way, also vendor your crossbows because they're hot trash and you don't need bolts. Alright, I was provided with some suggestions vis-a-vis how to deal with Patras, and essentially... he's slower than dirt, so don't expect to be able to cast spells too often with him in bigger fights. So look for items that you can give him that will let him, throw effects like powder bags and so on. So we now have food. We get some poison. Ooh, an icer. Ooh, that's tempting. Also, restores. These seem very cheap. I don't know, it might be because there's only four of them. Okay, so... I know I'm gonna need more food. We do have an herbal pouch with eight uses. No... I'm gonna sell it. I also don't want to check my funds. I can count. This is tempting, if only for some extra magic damage, but eight uses. We could also go with poison. Ah, oh, no, never mind. Be applied to foods. So we have three restoratives. And this is... if you were attacking, it might be useful to distract an otherwise troublesome opponent. Alright, I'm gonna give that to Patras. So these are in good condition. That is fine. Also fine. No. I really don't want to, but we're gonna need to buy some restoratives here. And by some, I mean like a shed load. Like I'm probably gonna spend... see, I think they stacked to what, 24? Damn it. Stacked to, I think, 24? Is it 25? 24, alright. So, okay, that's 10. 14. 22. Alright, so that's a couple extra, which I'm gonna probably force feed to these two dimwits. And I wanna grab... herbal packs are... ah, that's not too bad, actually. A gold apiece. I wish you could buy things in stacks. Instead of having to do it one at a time. I'm not gonna complain over much. But convenience features. Okay, we'll give one to you. Okay, I can't trade inventory items while we're in here. Good to know. We do have rope with seven uses. Okay, I was debating on whether or not to buy more rope. Although knowing that he's here, I suppose I could go loot bodies if need be. All right, so I'm gonna give you one. I wanna give you one. Give you one, I give you one. We have, like, I'm willing at this point to pay for food more so than I am restoratives. So, like, I'm totally fine just camping outside of town here for, like, 2 weeks. Alright, how long is it gonna take? Look at it go. Ah, you guys, alright. Turning around, going back into town. I'm gonna buy many more rations. I'd figured that we would have gotten more out of what we had than we did. All right. So I'll buy them each a stack of 28. And then depending on how we're looking when we're done, we'll go from there. All my money on rations. I was just town sold like pocket sandbags. Because since Patras is, you know, slower than crap, like that would be really handy. All right, here we go. There we go. That's what I like to see. James is actually pretty healthy looking. Like he's got some, I love it. He's probably like all told a much better combatant than Locklear is, which is just hilarious to me. All right, 54. What I should do is have a directory of saves for like every chapter, but that would be intelligent. Okay, so how are we looking here? 84 accuracy. Oh no, his melee accuracy is much worse. Okay. Patras. Patras, I hate you. Let's see here. So I believe the only way we can really go is like south. So I guess we can just head down to like Den Camp on the Teeth and kind of poke around. Just wanna get on the road here. And let's poke around a little bit, man. I have to say that I am incredibly dejected that we don't have the spyglass anymore. It means I'm going to actually have to do due diligence when it comes to poking around. We have a group of things. I'm gonna save. It would appear that the game has spawned enemies behind us, which I suppose is reasonable. Wait, what? Although he'd been tremendous odds on various adventures, he knew the sheer numbers of opponents would easily overwhelm them. We won't be able to take all these fellows. Maybe we can try another tactic to get by them. Oh, really? What would you suggest? Look at that. Goblins everywhere. All right. Oh, and there's a bunch of them over there. I've gone the wrong way, as per protocol. Can I nap? Yes. Okay, so apparently we can't just walk is this the same thing? Nope, all right, so this is a fight we can actually get into. I see a witch hag, and I see an enemy caster and at least two ogres two casters. Three enemy casters, so this could be an immediate TPK. A little bit of tabletop terminology there for you guys. That stands for a total party kill. Damn it, Locklear. Man, James is glaring now. All right, and our primary goal is to take out these casters, which we're all terrible and can't do. Oh, Patras, you're kind of on your own, but I kind of need you. Oh, Patras, you're doomed. Kill it. Oh my God, James, I hate you. All right, so that ogre, I think, is fleeing. Why would the mage hag move into melee range? It doesn't seem too wise, and I'm sure, like, I'm just waiting for one of these things to just lock down Locklear, and then the fight is over, essentially. Thankfully, he can move. Locklear has got the move speed to him. Oh, no. Man, he is just mowing these guys down, and James is just getting the ever-loving crap kicked out of him. Oh, damn it, I didn't mean to move him. Alright. Yeah. James, half dead. That's okay, I've got restoratives. Here you go. Drink long and drink deep. Ridiculous. I don't know, like, I can't really complain much because up to this point, all right, so he's back into, how many did that take? God, 20 of them. I can't really complain over much because like the last couple, I would say the last couple chapters have been fairly easy with Owen essentially, you know, providing party-wide invulnerability, locking enemies down and so on. So I can't be like, oh, the game's hard now, I hate it, because I'm totally up for some challenge. I'm also up for looting the dead. Because you guys better believe we are going right back to town. I'm selling all this crap. Alright. Now, I think town's off this way. But first, let's repair. Because it'll be worth more money if we repair it. And this sword is in some really bad condition. Can I do any more? No. I tried. Okay. See, this is... Yes, this is essentially paying for all the rations and stuff that, you know, we have been using up to this point. Like, yeah, that's 23 right there. That's not bad. It's mostly the weapons that, like, are worth good money. Look at that. 77. Nice. Yeah, so I'll keep that in mind. Go less for armor and more for weaponry. 60 sovereigns. Nice. So I think we're actually at a net gain now on income. Whether or not that's gonna last, I don't know, but... 32 and... I totally forgot that we actually had this Black Nimbus spell. We should learn that. Let's go ahead and use it. Alright. Does it tell me? Oh man, I totally forgot to get my notes and stuff pulled up before the session here. Normally I have my web browser and stuff open to my website that gives me the Mordhol combinations that I'm too stupid to figure out. And then the one that has, like, detailed information on what items and stuff do. So does Black Nimbus. Oh, that's right, that's the one that destroys the trap components on a battlefield. Alright, so I think we were over here-ish. Maybe. Let's kind of slowly creep forward. Because I don't want to accidentally blunder into anything. And it should have been, like, in this... They were not alone. Patrick's pulse quickened as he saw the lone figure approach, but when it became apparent that they were not being attacked, he relaxed a bit, scooted slightly in an attempt to see who was about to join them.
I was wondering where you two were.
Duke Martin. I knew when I saw Senor Locklear prowling about the Baron Gabbett that you couldn't be far behind. How's my princely brother, Arutha? When I first saw him, he was outside of the Dimwood with a small force waiting for my messengers to reach him. What are you doing so far from Cry D anyway? Brianna, are you hunting rabbits for Duckle Stew? No, but soon we four will be hunting four larger game than that. Seems this small wrinkle developing the Northlands is about to become a kingdom problem if what Locklear told me was correct. I'm just glad to have you two here to lend a hand. Is King Liam going to join the party? Doubtful. This engagement isn't serious enough to warrant bringing the king into it, and he's got his hands full enough with the Keshian Empire. Seems one of our kingdom ships accidentally mistook one of her empress's imperial frigates as a pirate ship and sunk it with all hands on board. Naturally, Lord Hazra Khan is having a conniption. We'll have to fight our North Warden's battle on our own. And what can Locklear and Ike do? I have most of Baron Gabbett's rangers out checking up on the movements of the enemy, so I'll need you three to give me a hand with various missions. You three are in the mood for a bit of running about? Okay. So we'll... Baron Gabbett told us you were to report. We were to report to you until the siege begins. Where do you want us? I was just playing a little fun. Petrus, how's your Mordhall? Which one you talking about, Duke? The one I got under my bed, or the one that makes me breakfast in the morning? Amazing. Jimmy, is it just me, or does Petrus remind you of a certain admiral we both know? Think he and Amos Trask would either lover each other or hang one another from a gibbet. I think the Duke meant how well do you speak, Mordhall Patras. I know perfect well what he's a-saying, you court rat. I can read it, but don't ask me to pronounce any of that dog howling yeehaw. I like Patras as a character, he's just terrible in combat. You won't have to for what I have in mind. There are some boxes near here that have Mordhall plates on them. I want you to crack the codes on them. I imagine these boxes will have supplies of rations for the Mordhall once they begin the siege. But I doubt they'll suspect we've tampered with them. If there are any rations, find a way to poison them, and then replace them in the boxes. Come back and find me once you're done. Alright. Prince Arutha has told me on several occasions you're about the finest archer he knows. Arutha also used to tell his sister Caroline that his father was going to rope her to the mainmast of Krondor's glory so the Queegians could have their target practice when they passed her in the harbor. Doesn't mean it was true. And I wasn't Jimmy the Hand. You're being modest, Duke. So I might be handy with a bow. Why the interest? I was hoping you could give Locky and I a few pointers. We both could stand to learn a little about how to use a crossbow more effectively. Well, as the Mordhall don't seem to be charging down our throats this very minute, I suppose I might be able to teach you a little bit. Myron sighted his crossbow and fired. Feathers drifted from above as the lifeless sparrow crashed through the branches to the ground, a crossbow quarrel neatly driven through its head. It had been dead even before it touched the ground. "That's incredible," James said. "At that range, I would have thought it impossible." "No," Martin said, as somewhat enigmatic as he knelt to touch the bird at his feet. "I've hit them at twice that distance, so it was merely difficult." Handing his crossbow over first to James and then to Locklear, he gave instructions as each attempted similar shots. "You both have made some progress," he said. "Just keep doing what you started doing today and you'll make fine marksmen." "Well, at least that answers a few questions. We'd best be back at getting this battle in order. Is there anything else you need at the moment?"
Just for you three to be careful. We can't afford to lose any more men."
"I think we can handle that order. You stay out of harm's way as well, Duke. Aretha wouldn't forgive me if you somehow got an arrow shot by some goblin archer. Farewell." Alright, so we've got to poison some Mordhall things. And our, I assume, marksmanship. Wow, 28 and a 65, alright. So James is useless with a crossbow. Locklear is probably also about, you know, about there. Alright, so we need poison. There was that Koltari poison in town. Well, here's a pile of corpses. You guys got anything good on you? Yeah, you do. Why didn't I loot it? Oh my god. So I assume that's what we're probably supposed to use because it says it's slow acting, so it's not useful in combat. But I assume if we poison rations with it, that will get done what we need to get done. Alright. Oh, damn it. Went the wrong way. This should be an easy fight, though, I think. Yeah. Well, I say easy, but I mean, I suppose I should better phrase it as manageable. Okay. Locklear. I don't know which is a bigger threat, the Mordhall or the Goblin? I assume the Goblin? Alright, Patras with his princely one hit point. I'm gonna see what this does. Wing this dude with it. It killed him! Alright, Patras, you are truly a king amongst men. Man, seriously, am I gonna die in this fight? Seriously, just freaking one-shot him. Oh my lord. "This is a manageable fight, you guys," proceeds to get the ever-living shit knocked out of him. Disappointment. Disappointment, thy name is Krondor. Alright, well, at least now I know, since I'm right outside of Northward, and I can just turn around and go in and buy some. Oh, this is right before this fight. Alright. So I want to see, all right, Potio Noxum. I want to see what this stuff actually does. Let's see, I assume this is a miscellaneous other item. Potio Noxum. If used while standing next to an enemy, he will run away. Extremely useful to spellcasters. Well, that's not what it did at all. It killed Patras instead. But I'll keep that in mind. Alright, let's do this. They seem prepared. Alright, at least we didn't get ambushed. James, you're just terrible. Patras immediately getting locked down. Kill it. Alright. So this guy's not gonna be able to cast, because James is next to him. He's dead. Beautiful. Alright, James. Harass the spellcaster. I don't really care if you hit or not. Attack Locklear or defend. Either is acceptable. God damn. James, you're just terrible. You got a freaking 76% chance to hit. There you go. Ah! I was hoping we could get through this without anybody going down, but alas, it was not meant to be. James dancing in the background, completely ineffectual. Can you do it? Yes! It's a small miracle. I'm not worried that we lost Patras in this fight, because the drops off of these guys will pay for his, He is... God, words are hard sometimes. We'll pay for his restoratives. Get the guy in the back. Another sword. Nice. Money, key, sword, and... sword. Alright. Nice. Yes, use the armorsmith's hammer on it. Okay. Everybody except Patras appears to be well off. Patras develops a drinking problem. Although he shouldn't need 20 of these things because his hit point pool is not nearly as high. Maybe. Yeah, there we go. How many did he need? Not 20 of them. All right. Noted. I'm sleeping. Give everybody a chance to heal here. Okay. So, I think it was this way I was going where I talked to that guy, right? He's like right up here. Tentatively. Maybe not. Well, maybe he's right over here. Yeah, here we go.
I was wondering where you two were.
All right. Let's just bump through this really quickly. Talk about the Baron. Let Patras be an angry, senile old man. All right. Now I'm gonna save because cowardice. We're gonna turn our happy butts around. But no, like I said, I'm certainly appreciative of some challenge coming back into this game. I'm not gonna say that I was having a bad time on the previous episodes, but like, it was basically the point where combat was kind of more a formality because things really couldn't do anything to me. Okay, shopping time. Let's vendor some stuff. I did not loot bodies on the way back. I think I'm really only missing out on a little bit of money though from that, so I'm not overly worried. Alright, do you sell Potion Noxum by any chance? No. Alright. And we want this. Yes, applied to food and drink. Give that to Patras. Chapel's armor and weapons. Gonna go ahead and pass. We're gonna buy more of these though. 16, 20, 24. Alright, so you should have. Did I go two over? Of course. One over, rather. Because counting is hard. Along with words. Pretty much anything requiring, you know, higher brain functions is beyond me at times. Alright. So let's go see if we can't. Maybe poison some things. And we will camp. Because night has fallen. Oh, is this our...
Where you two
yeah,
were?
Yeah, yeah. We have nothing to say to you, Duke. Yes, just continue on. All right, anyways. Something tells me I just skipped important conversation there. All right, I think this is the group that we bumped into last time. Yes! Thankfully, this time we're at least healed. Although, I can't imagine that's gonna help us all that much. Oh, you guys are terrible. All right, Patras, use this on, I guess, this goblin. Damn! Crossbowman's a stone-cold killer! He's fleeing. That guy's fleeing. You need to stop. Like, if they want to run, I'm totally okay with that. I wonder if I could use healing items on Patras in the middle of combat, but I don't think it works like that. Alright. Yeah, you're not going to be able to chase him down. I think Locklear's poisoned. I think Locklear is poisoned. Locklear, are you poisoned? No, you're not. All right. Sword. And, ooh, another sword. Poisoned rations. Fancy crossbow. Poison bolts. Okay. So I can't come out this way. Alright. I'm not, like, warded in or anything. Patris, you are just the worst. So fragile. Come on. One more. Oh, Jesus. Come on, man. There we go. Go ahead and rest. Give everybody a chance to get their HPs back. So, we're looking for more hall boxes. Can Patris do any? No. Okay. Maybe he can. Instead of Sarah can, Eyes of Eye Chap. This is what we're looking for. I don't know what the difference is. No. Nothing. Let's try it again. I fouled it up? Really? Am I not, like, casting it with enough mana? No. He's just that terrible, apparently. Old people and poor vision, guys. It goes hand in hand. Alright, well, we are looking for more at Hallbot. Oh, here we go. Let's see if this goes the same way. Alright, so this is the same thing he said last time, so we'll actually read it this time. Things are not going well at all. Starting to get reports that some of our scouts, and from the sound of things, this will not be an easy siege. So what's you looking for me? Well, actually, no. When I first saw you, it occurred to me to ask you something, but whatever it was, it has utterly slipped my mind at the moment. Would it bother you if I come and ask you about it later? We have a few things we need to be attending to elsewhere. I'll go on then. I have a few things to do myself. You're most gracious. Thanks and farewell. Alright. Whatever. Alright, so if I were hidden things, I'd probably throw them like... Oh no! We have wandered into a trap! So yeah, this is probably where we're supposed to be going. Yeah, I see chests! Oh, we have puzzles that we actually need to do here. This actually looks pretty straightforward, though. I just need to move Locklear here. And then push this. Okay, Patris, you just stay right there. And now we should be good. Yeah, straightforward, easy, gotcha. All right. Okay, so we got more at hall boxes. Hopefully the game will be taking pity on me, so I want to see. Patrick scanned the runes embossed on the Mortal clue plate. It's text, their only hope of opening the difficult word lock. Oh, can he actually? Okay, so yeah. You can see that he actually can't read it. He says he can. But he can't unless we cast Union, I believe. Yes, read Mortal for 20 minutes. Okay. It doesn't live within a house, nor does it live without. Most will use it when they come in, and again when they go out. Well, that's probably a door, if I had to guess. I figure they're gonna make these, like, super obvious. Because people like me will be playing. Alright, I hope six poisons is enough. And just in case the game's gonna be buggy, I'm gonna get his rations out of his inventory. So that I can do these specific rations. I assume these are now poisoned. No. But it uses... Okay, I'm gonna assume this is poisoning them. Alright. This side of a wolfhound has the most hair. What? Like, I have a feeling this is probably like a play on words. But I am not seeing it. So I am gonna look this one up. I was thinking they were gonna make these easy, but apparently not. Oh, it's the outside of a word. Ah. Oh, damn it. I was on the D already. Yeah, I would have never, like, my brain just does not work like that. Oh, hey, we have rope. Ooh, I'm gonna take it. I don't know if we're gonna get in trouble for taking stuff out of these, but I'm going to. Game's giving me loot. Okay, so these are obviously a different item because it moves them in our inventory, so that lends me hope that it's actually working. She has tasteful friends and tasteless enemies. Tears are often shed on her behalf, yet never has she broken a heart. Is it a knife? No. Tasteful friends and tasteless enemies. Tears are often shed on her behalf. And never has she broken a heart. Like, I feel like I should be able to get this one. I was thinking maybe a thief. Because, you know, she doesn't, like, break hearts by, like, you know, betraying somebody. She just steals from them and they're sad because they take her stuff. Well, she takes their stuff. I have no idea. As per protocol. It's an onion. Another one where I would have never gotten that. Oh my gosh, it's great. Oh, and naturally there's gonna be fucking three of them in here, so I have to make another trip back to town and buy another one of these damn things. All right, that irritates me. I'm gonna try poisoning just two of them and see if that's enough. Like, if I need to poison this last one, I'm gonna be pissed. Because that's just, like, the game devs being shitty right there. Alright, back out on the road. And I want to check my map so that I'm not accidentally wandering, alright, into death or something. So we should be able to just come, like, this way. And he should be, like, yep, right here.
I was wondering where you two were.
Poisoning, here we go. We've poisoned the food in all of the Mordhull lock chests we could find. There weren't many of them out there. We probably found the majority of them, so I wouldn't worry about it. There's something else I need you to do. There was a minstrel that the Baron employed here, a Northwarden by the name of Tamney. When he got word that the Mordhull were beginning to move down from Reglem to Northwarden Pass, he picked up all his things and disappeared in the middle of the night. The Baron is insistent he be brought back. The Baron mentioned this Tamney to us as well. But why is it so imperative he come back? Surely the men might feel a little betrayed, but if their morale is that shaky. The Baron sent word a while ago that a Nighthawk was discovered within the confines of the castle this morning, and there's evidence that there may be others. Naturally, word is spread and the men are edgy about the whole matter. If it doesn't help matters, Tamney never administered an oath of loyalty. And it's possible he was connected with the Nighthawks, I understand. Find him and get him back to Northwarden if you can, but don't let him know you're suspicious. He might bolt. One of Gabbett's scouts told me there may be goblin activity in the north, so hurry back when you're finished. I may need your help. Alright, well, I'm glad that they were merciful and we didn't have to actually poison all of those things. Alright. I appreciate the corpse in the background. I just noticed that it actually uses, like, the background of the area we're in. Like, so we saw these corpses there. That's kind of a cool touch. I will give them props for that. However, we are sitting at 35 minutes, so I'm going to go ahead and call it here. I will see you guys next time. Apparently, we're hunting Tamney. Until then.